The city sparkles to the southeast of our block. Here on Briggs Avenue in the north central Bronx, the landmarks are less glamorous. But the night's excitement always begins about 11 on the corner of 194th Street.
What do we do?
Yeah.
We enjoy our game room. We have a game room over here. We enjoy our pizza shop here.
Mm-hmm. Oh, we just...
Our block's night people take their fun where they find it. I happened along, so a part of tonight's game became Let's Play Reporter.
Yeah, how do you make money?
Just by hanging out, that's
oh,
all.
Oh, come on, you can't make money.
Tell me, is there any drugs in this neighborhood?
Oh,
really now.
What
no
do you
drugs?
Want a cop?
Ain't no drugs there.
What do you want a cop? Tell me now, all right. Here's an interesting fella right here. Excuse me, sir. You're from the neighborhood, right? Tell me, what happens in this neighborhood?
I don't know. I just came up on one.
You don't know nothing.
Their humor veils deeper feelings. A lot of anger and frustration here. Some of the people on our block hustle hard to survive.
Yep, end the conversation.
Definitely.
Oh, can't talk when the cops are around.
It's like two different teams, like police and us. Like we're on one team and the police are on another team. See, it might sound a little weird to you, but if the shoe was on the other foot, if you lived around here every day and you had to come around here every day, or you didn't have a job and your family was hungry or needed clothes or so on,
you would do anything you could.
You'd be surprised what you might do. I mean,
if a man's out here trying to sell drugs for his life, for his livelihood, to feed his family, I can't blame that. I can't blame that man for that.
How do you deal with that?
Ain't nothing you can really say. You gotta mind your business out here. Unless you end up in a box, 6 feet under.
6 feet under, that's it.
This street rhetoric can turn to ugly reality. It wasn't always this way at our neighborhood tavern.
A few holdups. It was just twice. Came in, made Tommy, somebody else lay on the floor, had me here, a gun in my face, a gun behind my head. Just took what they had to take and they left.
In this area here, which looks fairly innocent during the daytime,
yeah.
At night it's like Pirate's Cove. All the little gremlins come out of their caves and they hang out and they plan their little things and they buy their smoke and they give out their smoke and they plan what they're gonna do the next day or sell their stolen property or so forth.
Detective Irwin Silverman, Senior Citizens Robbery Unit, the 4-8 Precinct.
Now, a lot of people consider marijuana or smoking a joint not that serious.
Yeah.
But what happens is in ghetto areas where kids don't have too much money, when they walk down the block and they want to buy a joint or a $5 bag of smoke,
yeah.
And they look in their pockets are empty, the little old lady walking up the block or a little old man, that's a bang to them. They're going to make a withdrawal from that old man or that old lady.
Police may not be the only protectors on our block. Meet Cato.
We're called the Bronx Supreme Boys. And the only problem sometimes we have is people from the outside. That's
really?
All. Yeah. That's it. We watch all the kids out in all the schools out here and make sure nothing happens to them.
Yeah.
And when they do, believe me, we take care of it.
You take care of the
yes.
earth.
Yes. Definitely.
No.
I
think
you say there's dope here, miss.
I know there is.
Are you
where?
There's
angle.
Dope here.
I'm not getting involved in anybody.
How you gonna say there's dope here?
If anything, your goddamn people put it here.
Yeah.
That's right. How the hell you think it got here?
Yes.
How you think it got here? How you think it got here?
Not a big fight, just a squabble. Bitterness here on Briggs Avenue.
I just got home last year. This whole block has changed. I was taking a permanent personal vacation, you know? All paid expenses by the state.
The beat of this street enriched by jailhouse sarcasm and the music of our times.
What's your name?
Dynamite.
Say what?
Dynamite.
Okay. I'm gonna
what do you do when you're not
$150.
Playing
doing this?
Yeah.
What I do? Play numbers across the street in the bookie joint.
So what I'm gonna do is...
oh yes, there's off the track betting on our block. Most folks here call this the numbers hole. To some, legitimate recreation.
Have you ever hit?
Nah. I would play for my mother every Saturday, so.
You bring the number down for mom, huh?
Yeah, because she's sick, so I go play for her.
That shouldn't bother me.
But it's not bothering me. They're all in New York City pay numbers.
Yeah, all New York plays at something. Round here, fun runs along sidewalks and in hallways.
America, America. You know, I'm Italian, but I'm American.
Hello.
It's like I love Italy like my mother, but I love America like my wife.
If it was me, I would go out every night. If I had the money, go out every night, go to Manhattan, go to the movies, rent a limousine, go in class.
So I'm glad y'all are here, though. Because, I mean, this can go on forever and nobody never listen. I mean, for somebody to just say something about it, nobody never listened to us. Or even care. I mean, y'all listening now, not saying that y'all really care, because I don't think nothing's going to change out here. I think next year it'll be the same thing and so on and so on.